Hare Krishna, everyone. I am greatly honored and to be able to speak right now to all of the devotees who are going out on book distribution.
The Prabhupada Marathon, an annual event every year since the early 1970s, the ISKCON world comes alive.
The marathon is a special opportunity to go beyond your normal comfort zone. It is a difficult time of year, especially in this country, because it's cold, sometimes it's wet, sometimes you may not have the right footwear or the right clothing or the right hat. But if you take part in it, everybody who takes part in it absolutely would recommend it to anyone else.
It's the best thing that you could ever do in your life. I mean,
this wonderful and amazing time of year where everyone becomes so excited, and it's just this huge buildup to the actual Christmas day. And I can't think of anything at all that I would rather be doing at this time of the year than to distribute Srila Prabhupada's books.
I've done many things, but nothing comes close to that.
You go beyond your level of comfort, and that puts you in your stretch area. And it's good for us to be in our stretch area because that pleases Krishna, and pleases Guru.
We're here to make sacrifices, not here. We're not here to make comfort zones. That may be, you know, maybe that's there also, but that's not our business. Our business is to perform yajna sankirtanam prayer, to perform sacrifice for the pleasure of the Lord. And this is the greatest sacrifice in this Kali Yuga. Prabhupada, practically we're spreading this movement through the distribution of these transcendental literatures.
You really realize that actually when you're out on book distribution, you're actually really situated in the self. That is actually really who you are. And the person that we are the rest of the time, when we don't want to go out and all of those things and we're mature anxiety, that isn't really who we are.
We should go on Sankirtan in order to get life.
Marathon means full focus on book distribution, full focus on our service. And that means Krishna consciousness. So we can't do marathon all year because we are conditioned souls. Respect for those devotees who are not. But my Guru Maharaj said that marathon is good because then we can do what we have to do all year. So we have to practice to be fully Krishna conscious during that marathon. And because of that is this full focus on the service, Krishna gives extra miracles during that month. So marathon is just life. If there is no marathon, there is no life for me.
Because there is a very important principle in spiritual life, and that is by blessings, everything is possible. Don't delay, get the wind of blessings. Prabhupada used to say that he feels very grateful to those who distribute his books.
Where will we be without mercy? How will we ever go back to Godhead this lifetime? If it depends on our performance in devotional service? At the end of our life, we'll just need that little added mercy of Srila Prabhupada. Just when they're looking at our case and say, what about this one? Shall we let him in? They go, better he does it one more time. But then there's Prabhupada. Okay? So that will make all the difference.
So the winter marathon is upon us, and it gives us all an opportunity to go out and be a part of the biggest Sankirtan party.
Sankirtan is much more fun when everyone takes part. It's also easier when everyone takes part. And there's more of a team spirit and a real family feeling when the entire temple or the entire group is involved. You can have a lot of fun.
When we all go out and distribute books or work together to assist others going out on books, it brings that Prabhupada talks about unity and diversity as the key factor in our success of our movement, practically speaking. And book distribution, if we work together on it, even if we're not doing it every day all together, but the marathons give us all a chance to get into that same enlivening spirit, the cooks. They're cooking, thinking how they can cook nicely for the devotees who are out there book distributing. Everyone's thinking in the same way, keep the temple clean, whatever it is. And all together, Let's try to see so many. Please Prabhupada. That's what the Prabhupada Marathon means. How to please Srila Prabhupada.
I'd like to read to you something that no one has heard before. This is the last paragraph of our family business, the great art of distributing Srila Prabhupada's books by Vaisheshika Prabhu, the acharya of book distribution in our movement. Conditioned souls are in urgent need of the vibration contained in Srila Prabhupada's books. In this world, people live as if behind the closed doors of rented apartments. In the darkness of ignorance, they settle for the seedy conditions of a temporary material body. They need Lord Chaitanya's devotees to knock. They need to hear Krishna's voice in the Gita. They need the light that shines from Srimad Bhagavatam. They are crying for it. Srila Prabhupada heard their cries and came running to help them. Let's follow in his footsteps by tending to the family business.
So at this time of year, going out on the marathon, it is the highest thing that you can do. You're benefited by going out and distributing books. The person you give the books to, they're benefited. The community and as a whole in general, the devotee community is benefited. The social community is benefited. The whole world is actually benefited.
So it's like a win-win-win situation, you know? So, yeah, marathons are definitely a very intense but wonderful.
Not only is this a great sacrifice, this is the sacrifice, not only is it a thing that pleases Prabhupada, everything devotional service pleases Prabhupada, but you know, this is like the thing which Prabhupada emphasized more than anything, maybe because it's a little difficult to do, but it pleases Prabhupada the most when these books are distributed. That's what the temples are for. Prabhupada said the temples are bases whereby we, you know, we distribute these books, just like they go out and take bombs out and drop them on the lap of Maya. That's what it's for. And the Christmas marathon, well, the obvious reason is a lot more people on the street, that's for sure. The second thing, people are spending. They tend to be in a little bit more of a spending mood. And they're a little bit more open.
There is the mood of extra sense gratification, that's true, with everybody stocking up their shelves with all kinds of foods and drinks. But it is a time in these countries when people do remember Jesus, they remember religion, they remember sharing and giving to other family members and making other people happy at that time. So people are naturally in a giving spirit. And when they meet someone who has a religious message, doesn't matter that you're a Krishna devotee, they meet you and they think, why not? I can avoid this person next year, any other time of the year. But this time of year, yes, why not? I should give something. And I know someone who will have this book.
And at Christmas time, we are all about giving. People are thinking that we're just there to take, but they have no idea that what we're actually doing is giving them the highest thing.
If you've never done it before, it's actually the best time to actually train and do and get into book distribution, because actually it's the easiest time to distribution of Prabhupada's books.
So we often find that people who would not give, they give at Christmas time. And it's very important then that we have double, triple, quadruple the number of devotees to assist them in their spirit of giving.
Let's give them a chance. It's not up to us, really. It's our job. It's just like if you work in a shop selling pants, you get a salary, whether you sell one pair, 10 pairs, 20 pairs, or 100 pairs. So we are working for Lord Chaitanya. Whether we harvest one devotee or none or 100, we are just doing our job.
So why should we take part in a marathon? Well, from my little experience in Krishna consciousness, you're guaranteed bliss, you're guaranteed happiness. There is no doubts about it.
And marathons are so wonderful because it's like intense books are coming out, you know, because, you know, like it's instead of raining cats and dogs, or you say pillars and posts, whatever they say here, it's raining Prabhupada's books. Books are going out all over, and it's such a wonderful, and even if you can have some competition who does the best, and it's so enlivening.
marathon is wonderful. I'll get off the mental platform, you know. Get so mentaled out. Thinking of this, thinking of what am I going to do? What am I going to do? It's so simple.
It's like getting into a swimming pool. Like when you first get into a swimming pool, it's a little bit cold. And almost the mind doesn't what really want you to go in. But if you kind of force yourself to go in and you start swimming around and you warm up, then you don't want to get out. And it's like that with book distribution.
Now, why do we go out on book distribution? Why do we go out onto the Christmas marathon? Because we want to make a difference to the world. Every book that goes out is making a little difference to the world and a difference to the person who's actually distributing that book.
Well, what's the alternative? To stay home and watch soap operas? Somebody somehow forces us to rethink our situation. So it's time for us to repay the favor by doing the same thing. Just go out and tell people the same thing they told you. Just tell them your story. Just tell them your story.
Even in the snow and in the freezing cold weather, getting arrested. Sometimes we get arrested every day. We didn't care. We'd straight away come out of the court and straight away start book distributing again, get arrested again. We didn't care. Just carry on. Preach wherever you are. Distribute books wherever you are.
We're actually performing the activities of a liberated soul. And actually, in a sense, in that moment, we actually are liberated. There's actually no danger. It's the safest place to be.
You know, when we're distributing books, remember Prabhupada's right there with us. Lord Chaitanya's right, Lord Nityananda, they're right there with us. All the great devotees are right there with us. We're just taking shelter of them. And the whole idea is to bring pleasure to Krishna, and that means pleasing his devotees.
If you go out and just try, if you go out and just make an endeavor, it's pleasing to Lord Chaitanya, it's pleasing to your spiritual master. Other services, obviously it's pleasing to the Lord, but from my experience, that this service of book distribution and preaching, it's like a direct contact with the pleasure potency of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
We couldn't eat, I remember, so many times. You just didn't have time to eat. And sleeping was like a nuisance, you know. There's no time. Just throw a few dates quickly down, a quick cup of milk or something. That was it. You're out on the street. It really was. It was like you weren't. It was like another energy flowing. It was an incredible experience when you look at it now. Just couldn't bear it that somebody was passing by without one of Prabhupada's books, or at least the opportunity. But maybe get one, you know. It's very difficult to do anything else. That's why Prabhupada said it's like samadhi. It was just an experience of complete absorption.
But the philosophy comes alive when you're out on book distribution.
Anta yoga vicharana bhakti yogena sevati. You felt like, you know, you were no longer in this world. And same thing, anytime we completely absorb ourselves in Sankirtan, especially in book distribution, Harinam Sangnam preaching.
I'm very much convinced that Sankirtan remains the most important project of our movement.
So we're going to get out there, we're going to warm people's hearts, and we're going to celebrate Lord Chaitanya's Sankirtan mission in the West that Srila Prabhupada brought to us.
And if we do it day after day, and the marathon gives you an opportunity to do that day after day, then we actually start feeling comfortable on Sankirtan. And when we start feeling comfortable on Sankirtan, then our whole life changes.
It's a party. It's a celebration.
One of the remarkable things is how easy it actually is when you develop a taste for it. And how do you develop a taste? You just begin. If you've never done it before, try it. You will like it. Do it with others so it's more fun. Do it in a short burst.
This is a great chance to really get into the spirit of full-on Ananda Bhakti, full devotional service.
Even if we can do an hour, even if we can do 2 hours every day in the marathon, 5 days a week, even 6, if we can, or even just a little.
Okay, so if I can just do it for this month somehow, if I can just put my life on hold, my personal desires on hold, and just kind of give myself to Prabhupada for this month, and just see how it goes. Try it scientifically, and you see at the end of that month, you give everything, and you see how you feel.
And age has got nothing to do with either. I mean, Prabhupada was distributing his copies of Back to Godhead in his 60s. My age, I'm 67, going on 68, so. I call myself Exhibit A. So there's no excuse in that part either. It can be done by anybody, anywhere, anytime.
Yeah, marathons are like...
So please, take this opportunity. You won't regret it, whether you go 1 hour, 1 day, or many days. Play some small part.
I would recommend that every devotee make all efforts they can to spend one. We used to, even if we were doing other services, we would try to do them as quickly as we could. So we would run out the door with Prabhupada's books. I remember running up Oxford Street as quickly as we could after service, trying to distribute as many books as we could.
Don't let anything get on top. You just remain fixed and focused and distribute as many books as possible in as nice a way as possible.
It's immeasurable how much mercy you will get and how much mercy you will be able to give.
This is the Krishna consciousness movement. We're not going to wait for changes in the world to happen from the non-devotee community. If any changes, positive changes, are going to happen in this world today, it'll be through the distribution of Prabhupada's books.
Go out and you will never be the same again.
May Srila Prabhupada's mercy be with you. Gauranga.
So everyone should at least distribute one book within the Christmas marathon.
You don't even know why you're here, where you're from.
Wake up, sleep your soul. Oh, you sleep your soul. Sleep, why don't you wake up? You don't even know, you don't even know. You're living a dream world. Sleep your soul. Oh, you sleep your soul. Sleep, why don't you